What the fuck is this piece of shit?
So guys, how are you? Hope you guys have had a good day or whatever. Because today my day was rough. Very rough, in fact, because of the whole I had to fix the old television bullshit. I had to pay £80 and all that shit. Because I forgot to do whatever. I didn't pay correctly, so I had to pay extra, whatever. One of the reasons why television subscriptions are fucking lame. They punish you for not paying your rent. But anyway, today I want to talk about some really stressful news. In the fact that Fanatics, of all people, are going to be the NHL jerseys providers for the next 10 years. So from 2024 to 2034. Which means I'll be in my 30s when they finally are free from their corrupt reign. And this dude alone just made me realize that they probably going to be one of the longest running jersey providers the league has ever seen, ever since its exception, with probably CCM and Reebok being close to it, because this is ridiculous. Like Adidas, they could not have actually renewed it for another 4 or 6 years, but Adidas themselves were like, oh, we want to give you some offers, like we want to actually include, like, boost more of this relationship. We can continue on, so we can continue doing more jerseys for you guys. And NHL, being the NHL, we're like, get your bitch ass niggas out. Get the fuck out of here, man. We don't need your shit. We don't need your German, successful German sporting ass here. We can do our own, man. So they decided that the best idea was to go and get Fanatics. Which is like, why the fuck you mean Fanatics? You mean that Fanatics, the one that pretty much every jersey collector considers to be the bane of their own existence. With their shitty quality, their shitty customer service, everything about them is garbage. In fact, I can even show you how garbage they are right now. Because believe it or not, I've been keeping this in wraps for a while. Yeah, I know my room is cozy as fuck. I know I need to paint it more and stuff. And if you're liking the video, please give it a like and sub. That would be really cool. You don't need to, but it'll be great. Alright. This is what my uncle got. I had to pay like £32 just to get this shit in. There we go. Thank you, uncle. I mean, I'm talking about Fanatics and stuff, but this is what I'm talking about. Because I don't know what this one is. Because one of these things here are Fanatics. I can tell by how lightweight one of them is. This one definitely is a lot. It has to be this one because it's the right thing. There we go. Yeah, this is it. So, we do motherfucking. I know this video is about to be about how Fanatics is a mistake, but I just want to hijack it by unboxing one jersey I was really looking forward to. And now I have it right here. It's Ovechkin. Look how cool it is. And even though this is Fanatics, the logo here actually is stitched up, which is a huge improvement, because this thing looks actually high quality. It's like, if Fanatics can do this for the breakaways, then maybe I can accept it, because the problem with Fanatics overall is that the quality is just garbage. last time I had the Knicks jersey, it was like a NHL, it was like a New York Islanders jersey. It was so, I think that was cool, but then I felt the logo was off. It was pretty much a sticker. I had the Arizona Coyotes on the sticker. And it just made me pick the days that, oh, fuck, Phoenix is not, it is not a good business. And I had a nightmare scenario that they would indeed come to NHL and become Jersey Devices, because I was like, there's no fucking way. There's no way Bretman, that Gary Bretman guy would be this retarded to choose Fanatics off people. But guess what? They're there. And the problem with Fanatics is that quality control is garbage. And also, since they're so garbage, I mean, this one here is exceptional because this one is stitched up, which is very, very impressive. They do this more for their regular jerseys, not just special event jerseys. That would be the only good about them being the NHL jersey provider, is that if they are to accept the task of being the main sources of the NHL, then they have to actually wake the fuck up and improve the quality of their jerseys. Like, to the quality of this, at least for their breakaways. If they become like this for their breakaway jerseys, then maybe there's nothing to really worry about, because this jersey, it's fire. It's really good. Especially the Washington stamp. I mean, I got lucky that I found it, bro. My uncle would be annoying about me. See, one of the problems with Fanatics being the main jersey provider for the NHL is that, for one, people won't be taking NHL that serious anymore. I mean, look at this garbage. Look at this shit. I just want to remove this shit, but I don't know how to. Hang on, I'm going to go online and search how to remove it, because this thing ruins the design. But anyway, the problem with Fanatics taking charge of the NHL is that with other leagues, they got Nike, they got Adidas. What does the NHL have? The company that's known for making mock wear, essentially. Essentially, like, prototype, cheaply made shit. Their main jersey provider is a second grade company. Like, that alone, I mean, the NHL is already struggling with being recognized in North America and other parts of the world, but now this, when I see that Fanatics logo, even an identical one with like the prime green stitching, like jerseys like with the Sabres one, even when the jersey has this type of amazing stitch effect like this, like look how the fur is bouncing off the light, it makes it look like it's glowing or something. Even when they have the NHL plastic symbol here, the fact that it will have the Fanatics logo here, it just makes it look cheap. It makes it look like some fake breakaway product or something. It doesn't scream authentic. It just ruins the prestige of the sport, in my opinion. It makes it look cheap, unfavorable, like, what the fuck kind of thing is this? It legit pisses me the fuck off. Like, what the fuck are you doing, NHL? It's not good for the sport at all. For two, they're going to start charging the same price as the Adidas one, which is a huge, 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 huge mistake, in my opinion. It's like, hey, it's going to be over $200 just to get a blank again, which is a problem. You can't convince collectors to spend that much on maybe you can, because the DMA jersey collectors that have the design school, they'll buy it. And for me, I'll admit myself that I might be interested to grab at least one authentic Fanatics one for the sole purpose of, like, if the design is cool, I'll buy it. But for the most part, I'm just going to stay away from it, because just having Fanatics jerseys just makes me feel sick. Even though I'm wearing one, so I don't know what the fuck I'm saying. Okay, I'm not gonna lie, I made this video as a bit of me having a mild tangent, just waiting for me just to
just to express my grievances for a while because of what happened today. But seriously though, them owning an NHL jersey vibe for a decade is horrible. If it was 5 years, that's cool. But for 10 years, I'm like, what the fuck? Maybe Fanax might do a good job. Because they said that the next 2 years, Fanax is actually going to use the same exact build material as with the other jerseys. Daddy, that's just what they're making. They're just going to change the logo to adapt the ugly Fanax. So like that shitty promo they have on Twitter about it was really horrifically bad. They were talking about, oh, look at us, we are the sole jersey fighters for the NHL, and they're showing up all this crappy breakaway. I'm just like, what the fuck are you guys bragging about, man? Your products are garbage, man. Why the fuck are you bragging about them? Talking about them being invited from the head for shit. I'm like, you're acting like this is a good thing. That video on is one of the most hateable shit I've seen in my life. I tried playing on the screen for a moment. You just realize how fucking shitty it is. Why are you guys bragging that you have the NHL now? You guys are aware of your reputation, right? That you guys are a bunch of fucking know-it-alls. You're a bunch of fuck-ups. And I just hate how these numbers, they don't feel right. Even though the regular Adidas one is the same one, number one, this one's just paper. Even then, this one's stitched like a person. Man, I just don't know. This is some pretty stressful news. If I was to rate this verdict, I would be like, I don't know what to say. It's just kind of like disappointing. Maybe I might want to open some more jerseys for you guys right now, because why the fuck not? I mean, I don't usually have the opportunity to make videos like this much anymore, because I'm more of a gaming channel at this point, because almost every content I do has to do with video games. And I don't know, like my schedule, I'm just debating myself on whether I need to upload this video on a game or something, or some game or games, or that game, I'm like, man, I want to talk more about hockey because I love the sport, man. But this news again, NHL's already having problems, this news just makes me go, bro, this sport is a fucking problem. You know what, for you guys, I might just show you guys unopen both of these jerseys, because why the fuck? I have one open. Might as well open this one. Alright, let's do this shit. I might have to cut the video just so I can provide context to what I'm doing. Alright, let's do this. I think this one has to be with a player that's used to be in the Canucks, but now he's an Ironer. I think you maybe should know about it right now, but it's a Johnny Canuck, and this logo, I love how it has that cream. Wait, let me open it up. I mean, I managed to find this when I was scoring through Fanatics for a while, and I was like, oh shit, they have this one. I always wanted this one. Man, look at this bad boy. This is just for a thumbnail pick. Yeah. Okay, so here the numbers is on the front and it's actually stitched up, which is surprising because Adidas. Oh god, oh shit, look at this. The fuck is this? And this team feels cheap as fuck, man, compared to like, compared to like this, which is actual laces, legit laces. This one here is like, it's fucking twigs. Ugh.
There's one thing I hope Fanatics can do is that they can fix the strings on the front here to make it look more natural. This thing's just, it's just horrific looking. Anyway, this logo, love how the bear is the one that's raised up, and so is the belt buckle. It's just such a cool detail. This logo is one of my favorites. I literally bought this thing because the logo just looks amazing. Sure enough, in person, this thing looks fucking baller. And here, this is actually used like a bronze material, which is like showcase it brightening it up or something. It looks a lot better than I imagined in person. Like through the leaks, I was like, eh, it doesn't look cool. But then I looked at it closer, I'm like, bro, I need this thing. Sure enough, that's why I have it. I love how this thing here is just cream. Oh, that's just lit. 53C. And guess what? There's no number patch here. Very unique feature. And here is Hovat. The guy is a real badass. It's a shame he left because he did a lot of good for the team. But man, this is honestly one of my favorite reverse retros. Vancouver. 1962. It's just an overall amazing jersey.
Thank you, Uncle.
Yeah, this one's the most special one.
Party style scene. Never played in some party style. Bless it. Straight up. Yeah, the wicked is song.
Bless it out of big body shining. So good that it's super rare to get. Sorry for an interruption, I was somebody I talked to a lot. Because I'm lonely, but hey, this is Easter Conference Stadium. Vegas. Oh, All-Star Game, 1994. It's a reference to the Miami, to the Dallas Stars. That is so good that I just want to wear it right now. Because I've been holding up and wearing this jersey for like a month now. Why the fuck did I do that? I do not know. But man, this jersey is fucking baller. I mean, look at this. God damn, this is stylish as fuck, man. The pink, the white, it just pops and contrasts is super well. Like the logo. God damn, look at that sexy beast. Oh man, this is probably one of the best jerseys in the league right now. And the problem with this is that it's super hard to find now. I just got lucky when I found it from some Canadian website. Because goddamn, this team, it's a masterpiece in terms of look. The teal blue, the pink, the white, the black, it just contrasts super well. Oh man, I'm just glad I have this. And this is one I'm going to miss with Adidas. They just have that quality standard. In fact, in my opinion, I think Adidas produces the most quality looking jerseys in any NHL. These jerseys look like fucking jerseys. Doing good. The color, design, the trimming. It has a very, very modern, sleek look that I think Fanatics, they might fuck it up when they make a brand new design the 2026 season. That's all I know is that Adidas, they did a great job. People hated them at first, but then they proved to the world how good they are. Because goddamn, you'll never get shit like this again. All I gotta say is fuck Fanatics. This logo, holy shit, the whole thing is raised. It has that cool scratch effect to it to make it look like it's light or spark, but it's not. It's beautiful, please. But all I gotta say is Fanatics, they're gonna make the NHL look like a fucking joke. They're gonna overprice their shit now. But the potential advantage of this is that since I'm UK and Fanatics has a shareholding in UK in terms of American sport, girl, this will give them an opportunity to advertise the sport a lot more and push the sport to be growing more in the NHL. Or in all of the UK, I mean, not the NHL, to grow more in the UK, because UK is a country that actually, believe it or not, we do have very, very strong Cole Foley. If the NHL pushes harder, we might be able to get more easier access to get jerseys to our homes in here in UK, because to get jerseys to UK, you gotta pay so much for shipping, all that shit. It's awful. Even the NHL site is so expensive. It's awful. And with Fanatics, they might be able to make it more streamlined and cheaper for us. But knowing Fanatics, they might not just do that. They might like just add like a bunch of cunts and just be like, we're just gonna charge you more. Just keep it the same, man. Cause we Fanatics and shit, niggas. We got it right in this bitch. I'm sorry. I just can't stop admiring this dude. God damn, this is... It smells so good. Oh, fuck. The smell of jerseys. The thing about jerseys is that they have a beautiful smell to them. But yeah, overall, NHL probably made a big mistake with this. Fuck Fanatics. I'm going to continue doing my CV video, so I can find a job, because all this job hunting is bullshit. And I'll play some Haze or something for my channel. Then I'll have some jello fries and chicken and go to sleep. Anyway, if you like this video, give it a like, sub, and subscribe. Because that'll be great for me. I don't know what I just did there, but whatever. Because I'm liking these type of videos. I might do more of them if I have the time and opportunity to do so. But I mean, I do, because I literally have no job right now. I'm jobless. I'm out of school. I'm working on CV. I'm just waiting for responses. So I can pretty much do whatever the fuck I want. So now I'm focusing on just painting and playing games and watching films. And I might go and visit an MK Lightning match and record it so I can watch an ice hockey match again, because I haven't done so in such a long time. Too bad the match is going to be this Saturday, because I can't watch it this Saturday because I'm busy. So anyway, love you guys. I'm logging out now.